Michigan leads the United States in growing pickling cucumbers, producing around a third of the nation's crop. Many growers are here in the Saginaw Bay region, where soils provide perfect growing conditions. Cucumbers are planted late May to late July and grow quickly to harvest. The plants produce bright yellow flowers that are male or female. For a cucumber to grow, pollen must be transferred from the male flower to female flowers. If only a small quantity of pollen is transferred, the cucumber may be misshaped. Cucumber flowers need around 8 to 10 honeybee visits in a day to develop properly. Here in eastern Michigan, as in much of the Midwest, pickling cucumbers depend almost completely on honeybees for pollination. Bumblebees visit a few flowers, but cucumber is a native plant of Asia and is not very attractive to our native bees. Honeybees live in large colonies. One-third of the bees are foragers, the worker bees that travel out into fields and the surrounding countryside to gather pollen and nectar. A large and successful colony needs a constant supply of both pollen and nectar. The pollen feeds and nurtures new worker bees. The nectar is stored as honey. Worker bees will travel 4 or more miles to find good forage, making them excellent pollinators of crops grown on a large scale. Having a large, healthy colony in your field provides more foraging bees to visit cucumber flowers during bloom. Cucumber flowers contain pollen and nectar. However, honeybees do not like cucumber pollen very much. They forage in cucumbers almost entirely for nectar. Only around 1% of their pollen intake comes from cucumber flowers. Instead, they collect pollen from other plants surrounding cucumber fields to thrive. Smaller colonies have fewer forager bees to pollinate cucumber flowers. For beekeepers, the lack of flowers means less honey, an important source of income. Other factors also stress honeybee colonies, such as moving hives during the season. Foraging bees need to relearn the landscape around them, and this reduces how much pollen and nectar they return to the hive. To compare hives on wagons to stationary colonies, MSU researchers place colonies in fields in late June. The stationary colonies were 9% larger by mid-July, 21% larger by the end of July, and 32% larger by mid-August. If cucumber fields are close to one another, stationary hives may produce better results for growers and beekeepers. Larger colonies will visit more flowers, increasing cucumber yields and producing more honey. Growers and researchers can work together to ensure honeybees have enough to eat and are healthy pollinators for America's crops.